Hello friends, once again I welcome you all on my YouTube channel. Friends, we have so many videos on my YouTube channel, but some of the important topics I added now, and these topics are, for example, confusing titles, poet laureates. So these topics are very much important because these are very IMP topics, we can say, and these are asked too much. Some of the questions, very basic questions, are asked from these topics that we don't know. Okay, so today's video is regarding poet laureates, and in our history of English literature we can find so many poets, so many great poets. Okay, but some of them were honored with the position of poet laureates. Okay, so let's see, first of all, what is poet laureateship? So it is just a position, an honorary position appointed by the monarchs of England. Yes, the King of England appoints the poet as the poet laureate. Whoever is holding this position has to write poems on important national occasions. Yes, there may be important national occasions every year on which the poet laureate has to write some poems, some verses. Yes, and he has to present in the court. Then it began with the pension to Ben Jonson by James I. Yes, so it is very much important. Ben Jonson was there as a poet, and he was provided some pension by James I, the King James I. This tradition of pension giving was started by James I. Okay, and Ben Jonson was the first person receiving such pension. But he was not a poet laureate, and the tradition of poet laureate was started with the Charles II in 1668. It was official start by Charles II. Okay, and it was started in 1668 when he appointed Dryden as the first poet laureate. Yes, Dryden was appointed as the first poet laureate by Charles II. So it was the official start of this honorary position in the England. Then the first poet laureate. When we talk about first poet laureate, we find that only one name came in our mind. It is John Dryden, and he was the first one holding this honorary position. He was from 1668 to 1689 for 20 years until he was dismissed by new monarchs of England. Yes, he was dismissed by them, by the new kings of England at that time, after 20 years of service as a poet laureate. And why he was given this honorary position? So his poem was published in 1667, entitled with Annus Mirabilis. Yes, Annus Mirabilis was the poem published by him in 1667, and it was a very popular poem at that time. It became a successful poem at that time for Dryden, which got him this position of poet laureate. Okay, and the third point, very important point, why he was dismissed by the new monarchs of England, because he refused to take the oath of allegiance to the new monarchs. Yes, he refused the order of the new monarchs, and that's why he was dismissed by the new monarchs of England. So friends, he was the only one poet laureate in the history of English literature who was dismissed before his death. Okay, or no poet laureate is there who was dismissed by any monarch of England, but Dryden is only the one person who was dismissed by the new monarchs. Then the second poet laureate. Second poet laureate is Thomas Shadwell, succeeded Dryden and appointed in 1689 to his death in 1692, for 3 years only. So Thomas Shadwell here was appointed by the new monarchs of England after the dismissal of Dryden, and Shadwell remained there as a poet laureate for 3 years only, because he died in 1692. So for 3 years only he remained there as a poet laureate. Shadwell began the tradition of producing poems for the new year and the monarch's birthday. Later it became mandatory. Yes, so it is very important, friends. He was the person who started this tradition, this custom of producing poems for the new year celebration and the birthday of monarchs. Yes, birthday of kings. And later it became mandatory for all the poet laureates who were appointed by the kings. Okay, so after Shadwell, everyone has to follow this tradition or custom of producing poems for the new year and the monarch's birthday. So other poets, poet laureates, let's see them one by one, because the important one were there. Dryden was the first one, and the second one is Thomas Shadwell, who started that tradition. So now other poet laureates, we will see just their appointing years and how many years they served. Okay, so here the first one is Nahum Tate. Nahum Tate was appointed in 1692 and served till 1715. So he served for 23 years. So after Dryden and Shadwell, the third person was Nahum Tate, the third poet, who was appointed for 23 years. He served for 23 years. It is a very long time. Then after him, after his death in 1715, Nicholas Rowe served as poet laureate for 3 years, from 1715 to 1718. Yes, so once again for 3 years, one poet laureate named Nicholas Rowe served, and he died in 1718. Then another poet laureate was appointed named Lawrence Eusden. Yes, Lawrence Eusden was there appointed by the monarchs of England, and he served from 1718 to 1730 for 12 years. Then Colley Cibber was there appointed as poet laureate from 1730 to 1757 for 27 years. So after Nahum Tate, he was the person who served for the longest time as a poet laureate, Colley Cibber. Okay. Then William Whitehead. William Whitehead was a person appointed for 27 years once again, in comparison with the Colley Cibber. We can see here both served for 27 years. Whitehead served from 1757 to 1785. Then Thomas Warton is there. Thomas Warton served from 1785 to 1790 for 5 years. Friends, these are the different timelines of their service as poet laureates, but I am going to give you some of the IMP highlights at the end of this video. So keep watching this video till the end. Then other poet laureates include Henry James Pay. Henry James Pay, from 1790 to 1813, he served for 23 years. So it is once again very long time he served for. Then Robert Southey was there after Pay. After Henry James Pay, Robert Southey, a very well known romantic poet of his time, he served from 1813 to 1843 for 30 years of age. Yes, friends, so Robert Southey served for a very long time. Then Wordsworth is there, William Wordsworth, once again a very well known poet in romantic era, and he served for only 7 years after the death of Southey. Yes, he served from 1843 to 1850. So only 7 years he served for. Then the biggest personality in the poet laureateship was Alfred Lord Tennyson. Yes, friends, he held the post between 1850 to 1892. Yes, so very, very long time, longer than any other poet served he served for 42 years of his age. Yes, friends. So after his death, the post was left vacant for 4 years. Yes, friends. So the post of poet laureateship was vacant after Tennyson's death because he served for a long time, and the monarchs was willing to give him a certain respect. That's why he left it vacant for 4 years. And after 4 years, he appointed a new poet laureate named Alfred Austin. Yes. So Tennyson is here very much important poet because he served for a long time. And a question can be asked that after which poet the position of poet laureateship was left vacant. So after Tennyson, it was left vacant. Then in 1896, as we talked, Alfred Austin was appointed after Tennyson. He was appointed from 1896 to 1913 for 17 years. Then Robert Bridges was there, and he was appointed for 17 years after Austin from 1913 to 1930. So 17 years he served for. Then here John Masefield we have, who served for 37 years. So after Tennyson, he was the second person who served for a long time. Okay, the first one is Tennyson, who served for a long time for 42 years, and then John Masefield is there, who served from 1930 to 1967. Then Cecil Day Lewis served for only 4 years, from 1968 to 1972. Then John Benjamin was the poet who served for 12 years only, and he was from 1972 to 1984. He served for 12 years. John Benjamin was the poet laureate. Then Ted Hodges was there, the poet laureate from 1984 to 1998 for 14 years only. Okay, then Andrew Motion was there for 10 years only. He was from 1999 to 2009. So he served for 10 years only. Then Carol Ann Duffy was the poet laureate, the only woman poet laureate, and he served for 10 years once again, and from 2009 to 2019. And then the current poet laureate we talk about, he is Simon Armitage. Simon Armitage is the current poet laureate, and he was appointed in 2019. So he is the current one. So from 1999, we can see here Andrew Motion, we can see here every poet laureate who appointed after 1999 served for 10 years, and after 10 years they retired. Yes, after 10 years they retired. So only two person we can see here, Andrew and Carol, who served and retired. Armitage is still, he is there. So he will serve for 10 years only. So this tradition was started with Andrew Motion. Yes, that we have to keep in mind. Other poet laureates just died, and new poet laureates were appointed after their death. That was the old tradition. So friends, some important, very very important facts I enlisted here. The poets who held the laureateship for 10 years of tenure rather than for the whole life are Andrew Motion and Carol Ann Duffy, that we discussed earlier also. Then Dryden is the only one who was dismissed from this position. Yes, that we also talked about. He was the only person who dismissed by the monarchs of England. No other poet laureate was dismissed. Then Tennyson was there for the longest time of 42 years. And the second one is Masefield for 37 years, and Southey for 30 years. So we have three different ranks, we can say, the first rank, the second rank and third rank. So Tennyson was the first one, then Masefield for 37 years and Sadi for 30 years. So we have to keep these things in our mind. Then Wordsworth, Tennyson, Austin served during the reign of Queen Victoria. Yes friends, Queen Victoria was the monarch of England at the time when we were not independent. Yes, India was not independent at that time. So it can be asked that during the reign of Queen Victoria, who were the poet laureate? Okay, and Alfred Lord Tennyson was also there in this list, who served during the reign of Queen Victoria. Then Thomas Shadwell and Nicholas Rose served for only 3 years. When it is asked that who served for the least time of period, so here we have two names, Shadwell and Rowe, that we have to remember. And the last one is, it was Charles II who began this tradition of poet laureateship with Dryden. So it is also once again very important, who began the tradition of poet laureateship with whom. So it was Charles II with Dryden, he began this tradition of poet laureateship. So these were the important facts, friends. Let me tell you that here I have uploaded many videos. You can see the thumbnails here, and these are the very IMP videos for your UGC NET English literature exam. So you can find these videos on my YouTube channel, and you can also follow me on these social media platforms. I am continuously uploading different things on English literature. Some of the MCQs I uploading on Facebook and and Instagrams and Twitter and WhatsApp also. So friends, follow me on these platforms. So friends, till then, goodbye, have a good day, and thank you.